Hello and welcome to another Unity tutorial. In this tutorial, we will see how we can use the cutscenes that we have learned to create in the previous videos. In this scene, I have a player, first person player, who will climb up the ladder. And by gliding the ladder, a cutscene will be start playing. So let's see how it should be. So as you can see, when I go up, and you can repeat and repeat the same progress. Okay, so I will just explain how I created this progress, and I will not create it now. So I've created the timeline that we have learned how to create a cutscene. If you have not seen the tutorial yet, you can see the link is in the corner of the video. So first, make sure your timeline, you uncheck the play on awake. This will be make your video not start playing on starting the game. Then you can achieve this by colliding an object or using ray cards or whatever you want. In this video, I used collider, and this is a trigger collider, and I opened the player movement. I used the template, the first person template from Unity, so you can just add to another script. If you want, I added to the player movement I created on trigger enter, and check if the trigger is a ladder. Then the timeline that I've created a reference for it, and I added it to into inspector. First, you make sure that you call rebuild the graph that will make your timeline restarted each time, and then you play it. Just it. And the important thing here is these activation tracks. So here we have two cameras. One is the main camera that we have for the player, and I created another cinematic camera, which is this one that you can see it's animated, and when the player climbs up, will show the player. So this camera should be active only during the cutscene. Therefore, I just added an activation camera track and added the camera, cinematic camera, into it. And I do the same for this character, because our game is a first person, and we don't need to, after the cutscene, see this character anymore. So I add another activation track for this character. And here I have just an audio track for the step sound, as you can hear. And also an animation track for animating the camera, as you can see. And for this character, I've downloaded a climbing animation from Mixdemo website and just imported to timeline. Another important thing is here, I created two signals. So for creating signals, you can just click on these timeline markers and right click and add signal emitter, or you can just add for example a signal track, and for each object you create a signal track and add the signals into it. But here, because I have just two main signals, I added here. And when you create, let me just show you how. For example, add track, and you need to create a signal and add a name to it. And after that, you can add different actions to it. I have for this start, I have two actions. One is I change the post processing volume, because in the cutscene I have a depth of field, but I don't want to have it during the gameplay. So let's play the game again. Here we don't have any depth of field, but when I go up, as you can see, the background is blue. So I just disabled and enabled, or just changed the post-processing profile. So you can just select your volume, which have the volume component, and then you can select volume and volume profile and add the profile that you want. So I just replace profile at the start and the end of the cutscene. In the start, I add also another action, which will deactivate the main camera, because we don't want to render both camera, it is expensive. So also again, I enable it at the end. And at the end I have here, I have an extra action, which is I just let me show. I create another function here, teleport, and it will just get transform, target transform, and move the player into it, and the direction also will the same. So just I added the player or the script, the object that have this script that you created, and then I called teleport, and then I have a object where I want to the player move after cutscene, and just I added the player, the object into teleport function, and that object is this transform target position. So in this way, you can just have many timelines and play them when you need them. The principle is the same. You can call them using code or by trigger, by raycast or whatever. Hope you enjoyed this video, and see you in the next tutorial.